In this lesson, I've covered distributed shared memory, and particularly I've given you a specific example of a distributed shared memory system called Treadmarks that uses lazy release consistency and multiple writer coherence. I just want to leave you with some thoughts about non-page-based DSM systems before concluding this lesson. There have been systems that have been built that do not use granularity of a page for coherence maintenance. I mentioned earlier that if you want to maintain granularity, not at the page level, then you have to track individual reads and writes that is happening on a thread. So one approach is what is called a library-based approach. Here the idea is that the programming framework, the programming library, is going to give you a way by which you can annotate shared variables that you're going to use in your program. Whenever you touch a shared variable, part of creating the executable is to cause a trap at the point of access to the shared variable so that the DSM software will be contacted and the DSM software can then take the coherence action at the point of access to that shared variable. So in this case, there is no operating system support needed because in the binary itself, we are making sure that at the point of access, we're going to result in a trap that will get us into the trap handler that is part of DSM software so that it can take the coherence actions. And examples of systems that use this mechanism include Shasta, that was done at Digital Equipment Corporation, and Beehive, which was done at Georgia Tech. And because we are doing this sharing at the level of variables, you don't have any fault sharing, which is possible with page-based systems and single writer cache coherence protocol. So once the DSM software takes the coherence action, which might include fetching the data that is associated with the variable that you're trying to access, then the DSM software can resume this thread that caused that trap in the first place. Another approach to providing shared abstractions is not at the level of memory locations, but at the level of structures that are meaningful for an application. And this is what is called structured DSM. So the idea is that there is a programming library which actually provides abstractions that can be manipulated in an application program, and the abstractions can be manipulated using API calls that are part of the language runtime. So when the application makes the API call, at that point, when an application makes those API calls, at that point, the language runtime gets into gear and says, what coherence actions do I need to make in order to satisfy this API call? All of those coherence actions are going to be taken at the point of that API call, and that might include fetching data from a remote node in the cluster. And once the semantics of that API call has been executed by the language runtime, then it's going to resume this thread that made the call in the first place. Again, there is no OS support needed for this, and the structured DSM is a very popular approach that has been used in systems such as Lynda, Orca, and Stampede that was done at Georgia Tech, and successors to Stampede called Stampede RT and PTS. And in this course, later on, we're going to see PTS as an example of a structured DSM system.